So, check. So, check. Okay, yeah. Let's check out John Tiller's Guadalcanal, another naval campaigns game, focusing on World War II surface combat. And yeah, before I do anything, because we will play this tutorial scenario, but I've noticed it in the two others. They are set to 30 minutes, which is for naval warfare way too short. So here, similar to those squad battles, I also recommend to do it for every beginner if he doesn't plan to be suddenly stopped in the middle of the battle. For example, for the Jutland one, it was absolutely impossible. Well, this is the time in seconds. 1800 seconds are 30 minutes. We will pump it up to 10,000 and decide on our own. Doesn't mean I will play it that long. Just so I can decide when to quit the scenario. Yeah, about the features before we start, let's get into the game, into the main interface. Here I will go through the battles and you can take a look at the scenarios. It is, some might ask, okay, you have Midway. You played Midway. What is Guadalcanal? First, sure, from the name, it is different. It is representing more the late war, late Pacific War stuff. And I think it has a bigger focus on surface, conventional surface warfare, less on carrier battles. So if you know, Pacific was most, or at least when it came to the initiative, it was about those carrier battles and aircraft. So if you want this carrier, this all aspect warfare, Midway is what you're looking for, which is also simply modeling the first battles. If you're looking more for the surface action, for ships slugging it out with each other, then Guadalcanal. Because you also have some PT action here and stuff like this. Destroyer battles, yeah, and also some hypothetical battles. I will show you some modded scenarios where you can even play huge battleship engagements that never happened in World War II because the tactics shifted, the doctrines shifted. But doesn't mean that you can't play it hypothetically and that you shouldn't be. Sure, you should. Yeah, okay, let's go first through the official scenario list. Below you have the description and you can pause the video if something interests you and you want to read it. So I think sometimes interesting to see what scenarios are modeled. Some people simply have a connection to a specific battle. Yeah, a lot of historical ones, alternatives, hypothetical, everything here. But that's not all. Yeah, maybe we can already load the getting started one. And we will play the Americans. Or the Allies. Okay, yeah, visible torpedoes and aircraft torpedo resolution. I will go again for those settings. Because, yeah, I can explain them again. This is that aircraft torpedoes dropped don't need to physically hit the ship on the map by driving right into it. It can be fiddly and I hope they will introduce at least some sort of prediction. Sure, you can do it by eyes, and but it means simply if the torpedo is close to the ship, there will be a calculation be done. A historical one, a historical hit probability of torpedo aircraft drop torpedoes will be aerial torpedoes will be simply used. And visible torpedoes is that you see torpedoes being shoot it around. You see even enemy torpedoes approaching without them being in actual visible range. So if you want to play most realistic and not having advantages, you turn this off. Okay. So let's leave the scenario open. We will play it, but I will show you. I did a mod copy or a folder copy of my install just for custom scenarios. There are some really interesting choices. For example, for people that looking for some hypothetical Russian action, yes, Soviet Union had also a fleet, didn't play that of a major role in World War II. But sure, I mean, the chance was there that they might participate in the Pacific War. And for this you have a battle where you can play the Russian fleet. Yes, there's some little US flag, but it is because the game engine, you could replace it if you need, because the game engine isn't built for having Russia, having the Soviet Union. But you see, the ships are new, the ships have historical pictures. I showed in my mod video, you can find out where you can download this stuff in my mod resources guide. And yes, you can add your own ships with it. And these are Russian battleships. Russian fleet. So if you ever wanted to comment, I don't know, sure, I mean, yeah, World of Warships, sure, but I mean, in a realistic sense, ever wanted to command the Russian fleet in a World War II context, here is your chance. I don't know any other game that offers this option in a realistic, in an authentic fashion, not in some sort of arcade fashion. Yeah, and you can slug it out here with a big fleet against something, some Japanese fleet. But that's not all. There are, I don't know what is also interesting. Ah, yeah, German fleet. There's even one interesting, I think it was this crazy thing here. I mean, I like the idea. For some reason, I mean, I guess it assumes a lot of hypothetical stuff. And you don't need to explain everything in super detail, but it is basically the Germans linked up with the Japanese. This time we will play the Japanese. The German fleet linked up with the Japanese in order to create a combined surface fleet. Historically, the cooperation between those two Axis powers was really little. It is also seen as one of the reasons why the Axis failed, that because they didn't time their operations well, and but whatever, it isn't. But here, both fleets join their forces in order to be the, I don't know, the super strong fleet. And you have a mixed Japanese fleet with, and they also assume that some ships were built which the Germans didn't complete. Yeah, you have, and again you see custom ships, and they also have custom values. German ships. I think the Tirpitz never was completed, right? It was the second ship in the Bismarck class and never was completed. At least they look similar. Yeah, and you will battle against a US-UK fleet. Also, I'm not sure, I think the normal game also has already UK assets, but there is a mod that even expands more ships. So if you're looking for surface action, Guadalcanal is more focused on really on surface slugging in a historical but also in a hypothetical sense. And yes, Midway is about carrier battles and air battles. Yeah, another with New Mexico US fleet assets. Okay, fighting against the Germans, a US fleet against Germany. Some hypothetical assumption that the Germans somehow, I don't know, improved their fleet and etc. These are our custom scenarios, but there might be more to find. I didn't look that much because I have so much stuff to play, currently not super in need of custom scenarios all over the place, but if you're looking for stuff, there might be more. Yeah, Battle of Norway. Yeah, here, King George, British ships. And I don't think they are part of the main game because also, again, the US flag. Perhaps the British are even... could be that it is shown as basically generic allies. But yeah, these are definitely British ships. And they look modded, definitely modded. That is not a standard ship, I can tell. So yeah, British fleet is included, making Guadalcanal probably one of the most extensive World War II surface naval surface warfare games you can get. Authentic ones. Okay. Yeah, that's it. And again, you have editors, scenario editors, somebody said me that they are not that long available, so you can change parameters of, so if something, you don't agree with something, I don't know, AA being too weak, torpedoes being too whatever, can even tell aggressive values, seems you can tweak the AI. Make submarines less noticeable, whatever. And OOB editor, did I show it already? Yeah, design your own formations and ships. Okay, and let's go back and play the introduction scenario. So we are destroyer fleet at, let's read the mission briefing again. Okay, it is a hypothetical defense by American cruiser force in defense of Guadalcanal. Okay, we have the armored cruiser San Francisco. Oh, interesting, the Americans, I think that's the first armored cruiser I see from them. Okay, yeah, let's go through the interface. It is like Midway and Jutland, there won't be that much differences. Big differences is introduction of radar. But first go through the interface. Okay, yeah, this controls, Turn to land. Yeah, aircraft controls. Multiplayer. Yeah, optional rules, we talked about this. Yeah, I play with this. And I play with. Nautical miles instead of. Yeah. So this is a nautical miles. Okay, here also looks very similar. Submarine controls, speed and maneuver controls, time controls, turn and battle controls, or battle scenario controls, map controls, and more map controls. Okay, so nothing new, I think. Good, we selected the AI, yeah, we did this, yeah, flagship. Check the Jutland video. It is also here the same. Flagships are yellow and have those little flecks, which is often, which is not that visible because of the names I have turned on, but you can also turn off the names if they, if you like, see those little symbols more, or turn other information on, like speed. Or group names. Ah, wait. I remember there was something like an order of battle screen somewhere. Because I'm still looking for a function to link up ships. Linking up those, for example, that the cruisers here follow those destroyers. That would be important for me to know. If somebody knows, let me know. Jordan Clisco, hi. Yeah, welcome. If there's a way to order this cruiser to follow this destroyer division. I think here it is not that, but in those big battles I want to simplify things, especially Guadalcanal and Jutland are focused on surface warfare, which is important to keep formation and everything, so that it would be important for me. I know you can, I guess you can do it by editing the scenario, or the editing the OOB. Ah, yes, the OOB file. Let's take a look, let's say... But because every scenario comes with this, or almost every scenario comes with those OOB files. Okay, I'm in the wrong folder. Yeah, Bismarck. It's a Bismarck scenario. I think Guadalcanal comes with a Bismarck. If you wanted to participate in the last sale of the Bismarck, can do it. Yeah, I don't know. Let's load a cruiser night action. How does this look like? Ah, okay. Can I simply drag and drop stuff over? I guess I can. Cruisers on the right and they spotted something.